I guess you guys just hate cute jokes. That's fine. That's fine. It's gonna be pronounced Hoover soon anyway. Yeah, they bought it. Topical comedy. You guys ready for the next comedian? Good buddy of mine, up and comer in the scene. I really enjoyed what he's been doing so far. You guys are gonna enjoy him too. Make a lot of noise right now for Kyle Adams! So I was wearing this shirt outside of a comedy show, and a homeless man stumbled up to me and he said, "Looks like Walt Disney threw up all over your shirt. Can I have a dollar?" I said, "No, you cannot, sir, because you are already obviously high." And I just thought it was kind of rude. I really found it kind of rude, and I dealt with rude people. I used to work with rude people. I had a boss at one point. He had a conversational safe word. And I'll give you an example. You know what I'm talking about. He would say, he would listen to your conversation, and he would say, "Good deal." He'd be listening to your conversation, his face would start to tinge a bit, and I'd go, "It's coming." And he goes, "Good deal." And then he'd walk away, done with whatever you were saying. I'm at a different place now, which is good, but I get really, really high before I come in. I'm a food server, so you have to, because you guys are fucking monsters. Just be honest with yourselves, you're fucking monsters. I hate the vernacular that you guys use, like, you're like, "We're starving." It's like, no, you've never felt that before. I had a lady tell me one time, she goes, "My kids and I are starving." So I called Child Protective Services on her. Because, I mean, it's active duty. I'm a food handler. I have a food handler card and an OLCC card. I think that's part of one of the stipulations. Like I said, I get really high before I come into work, which is great because my managers don't give a shit about anything, but it's also terrible because my managers don't give a shit about anything. I'll give you a good example. During Christmas break, a hammer with a rubber mallet fell in our gluten-free fryer, and all the rubber melted. We didn't find out about this until January 2nd. And so every time someone ordered gluten-free fries, I would say, "Hammer time!" They have no idea what I was talking about. But they would be very upset if they knew I was revealing these secrets to you. They would say that snitches get stitches, but I would say once we find out what's in the gluten-free fryer, consumers get tumors a little more accurate. What would you say, sir, is the worst job you've ever had, hands down?
Janitor.
What was the worst part about being a janitor? Toilets, yeah, those are gross, right? Like, what was the worst scenario you've ever had?
Diarrhea.
Yeah. Give me some details.
Ground.
Good deal.